Hi guys, my name is Sanne and I play the hurdy-gurdy. I've been playing hurdy-gurdy for about 3 years now. This is my instrument here behind me. This is a traditional guitar-bodied hurdy-gurdy made by Chris and Sabina Allen from Wales.
Hi, my name is Jimmy and I'm a hurdy-gurdy player for almost 12 years now. I play two different kind of hurdy-gurdies, a traditional lute-back instrument, also made by Chris Allen and Sabina Cormillo. And this is my second hurdy-gurdy. This is an alto instrument, a viola model by Wolfgang Weichselbauer. And yeah. Today we are going to show what we carry around as hurdy-gurdy players.
Yeah, just our bags and belts and other stuff. Like maybe you've just ordered a hurdy-gurdy and you're like, okay, now what? Well, this is the stuff that we have and that we carry around, so maybe you will find this interesting.
So,
bag. We both have semi-rigid backpack types with straps on the back. Personally, I don't want to have a flight case because it doesn't make sense to me. I'm not in a touring band and I don't fly and I do a lot of my travel with public transportation, so I wanted something light and portable, and I think it's quite similar for you.
This one is quite similar. It's a bit bigger because your instrument is more compact than mine are. This one is made by Fusion Bags. I believe they are an Asian company and their bags are being distributed all over the world. This one is made for hurdy-gurdies.
Yeah, that's a standard hurdy-gurdy bag. This is a custom bag. This one was made by Lux Bag, which is a company from France. I'll put the link in the description down below for both of these brands. There are other options before you go custom. Like you can also look at certain kinds of brass instrument bags.
Yes. If you tubas.
I'm not sure. I think tubas are a bit big, but euphoniums, saxophone, that kind of stuff. Like depending on the hurdy-gurdy you play, it may or may not fit in there, because these both of them they don't come really cheap. But for us they work really well.
So what's inside?
What's inside? I have a belt. Let's start with that.
I think a belt.
That makes sense.
Great.
We both have the same belt.
Yes, we do. Let's see.
These are made by Sergio Gonzalez from San Fernando. And it's a three-point belt. It has two connections on this end because a hurdy-gurdy has two strap buttons on the crank end and a clasp on the other side. It also comes with an extra shoulder piece. These belts, they were made specifically for busking and for performing, and you can strap it on and your hurdy-gurdy doesn't go anywhere, which is quite nice. Again, it's awesome quality. Again, they don't come really cheap. If you're just starting out, you don't need this. You can also...
But it's a nice one to have, because I think this is the best hurdy-gurdy belt I have.
Absolutely.
Yes, it is.
Absolutely. It is really good, but I think they retail for about 120 euros. So, yeah, it's not really cheap. But if you have the money, I absolutely recommend this one. It's really nice quality leather, and it feels really secure. But if you're just starting out and you're playing at home, a regular guitar strap will do as well.
Well, at least make sure your strap is tight enough, so your instrument is kind of fixed on your lap and doesn't wiggle too much.
Yeah.
Because it will make your playing easier if your strap is the right size, but that's quite easy to do.
Yeah, we see a lot of players who are beginning and they think that a hurdy-gurdy is like a guitar and that a strap is optional. It isn't really optional. You do need a strap because with the coupes, it's going to move on your lap. So toolkit. This is mine. This is just a toiletries bag. It's like anything you can do stuff, put stuff in will work.
You can use anything, but this one was...
It's a pencil case, right?
So funky. Yes, I believe it is.
It's a tuner.
Very handy. This is a small Snark brand digital tuner. You can clip it on the instrument. I believe this one is about 10 or 11 euros.
It's very cheap. It works fine.
And it works very well. Because as we all know, the hurdy-gurdy can go out of tune quite easily. And you need a tuning device.
Yes. And I also have batteries for that.
Very smart.
I am smart, you know me. I have spare strings. You don't have strings?
Nope. Not anymore.
I just have spare strings for my chanters. I have two chanters, a high G and a low G. This is what I'm using right now. This is Eva Parazzi Viola G. And this envelope contains my set of broken strings. This is another spare for my low G. This is a Thomistic spiral core. And I have a gut string. This is for my high chanter. And this is a Savarese. It's boiled, oiled gut in 0.94 millimeters. So that's what I play on. And I don't have any other spares. I mean, this is quite wealthy because hurdy-gurdy strings are expensive as
yes,
fuck.
They are. So what more do we have? Ah, this one. This is a small tin containing
the fluffy stuff.
Fluffy stuff. This is my little ball of cotton. And you have some more different kinds?
I have several baggies. Well, I can show you, but they're just basically little bags of fluffy stuff. But I use different kinds of fibers. I have a mix of bamboo and viscose. I have a bag of just regular cotton. And I have a baggie of silk. And the reason I use different kinds is because in my experience, they all have subtly different sounds. So I like to change the based on what I need and what the hurdy-gurdy is sounding like on
yes.
that particular day. And I also have in my cotton tin some pre-cut paper shims. And this is not something, this is just something that I like to do when I have a piece of scrap paper. I cut it up into these little strips. And if I need to shim any of my strings, I never have to look for paper. So that's nice.
So, what more do we have? Ah, this one is very important because the hurdy-gurdy is it's quite a loud instrument and you really need some hearing protection.
Earplugs! Protect your ears, kids! Really!
These are not very expensive, so I believe you can buy this kind of earplugs for 10 or 20 euros and they are worth it because you really have to protect your ears.
Yeah. I have here screwdrivers.
Ah, me too.
I have two. They are the same and for no particular reason. I bought this one because it was really cheap and I wanted to see if it fit on something, but it didn't. So right now they are both leaving in my toolkit. And this is what I use to tune my tangents.
These are my favorite things.
That's an interesting favorite thing you have.
Yes, I know.
Yeah.
And this one is also nice, but this is just a typical flathead screwdriver. And the other ones are much nicer. So, what more do we have?
I have here some bottle of rosin. This is liquid rosin. You can make this out of a regular block rosin and some pure alcohol. Take a glass bottle, the purest alcohol you can get your hands on, and some block rosin, and put some scrapings in there, and it will just dissolve overnight. So.
Same here. It smells nice, actually. And you don't need to use liquid rosin. Well, some instruments, it's better to use liquid rosin, but normally you can use the solid block rosin, like this one.
This is Gustav Bernadel Colophane. It's just regular violin rosin. And I use both. I use both liquid and solid, but solid will also work. So, and yeah, we have some rags.
This is I use
for the liquid rosin. And this is what I use to polish my wheel. And this is some really soft leather. I think you just use your rag for that.
Yes, this one is more crusty because I use it for as both, And I probably need to replace this one very soon. So there you go.
Yeah. So when you put on some new rosin, it sometimes is still a bit rough. So you polish it and then by putting a rag on there and then turning really, really fast, and you heat up the top layer so it gets more smooth. So you get a better tone.
And there's another bottle. This one contains alcohol.
Alcohol.
And this one is not for drinking, but it smells nice. Anyway, this one is used to clean the wheel of some dirt, because when you play in public, there will be many people who like to touch the wheel. And no. So you have to use alcohol once in a while.
Yes, yes. I have some shrink tube. This is, you buy this by the meter at the hardware store, and I have wooden tensions because I have a traditional instrument, and I have shrink tubed my tensions. You just cut a little bit off and then you put it around the tension and you heat it a little with a candle. And this is just a tiny rubber layer, and then it means that you can make a bit more clean contact.
So, yeah, some better contact.
Yeah, so you don't have a buzz at the beginning of your note. So that's nice. And this is very cheap and quite easy to do. I think it was worth it.
And this is my very small tweezers, used for guiding a new string in the small holes of the tuning pegs.
I use this these pliers for the same thing.
Those are better, I think. So
I also have some spare tensions and screws. See, wood. And I have another pair of pliers. I don't think you have these.
No.
These have a round beak, very smooth, and I use these to adjust the bearings of my axle. Sometimes you get a little play in the axle and then you have to take the crank off, and then you can use these to adjust the bearings so you'll have smooth action on the wheel. That's what I have that for. And that is my stuff. Yeah, I have a pencil and a hair tie. Because, yeah, I have very long hair and it does get stuck.
I need this one, yes.
Yeah, you do need that one. It does get stuck in the axle. It's like long-haired hurdy-gurdy player problems.
I know.
I think your beard still needs to grow a little bit.
Yes, I believe so.
You have some more.
Yes, I have some more stuff.
Because I am out right now.
What more do I have? Because this instrument has some electronics, some pickups to amplify the sound, and you need some more stuff for it, because this one has an output that connects with this one, and this is called the Blue Box. This one is especially made for this instrument, and you should use some more cables. Yes, it's always more to carry around. A wall wart as a power supply. This is the custom made cable. It has 7 pins on an XLR. And it connects to your instrument and to the Blue Box, and it carries all the separate channels and converts it into separate outputs and a mixed output. So you can connect every output to a different amplifier, which is very nice to have. And this one looks like a garden hose, but it's just a regular guitar cable. And so you can play louder even.
Which is good.
And this is all the stuff we carry around when we're going to play somewhere.
Yeah, I hope you find this interesting. This is our stuff. Maybe you'll have some useful information in there. And that's it. I don't know how to end this video.
Okay. Thank you for watching.
Have a great day. Bye.
Bye.